that's a south turn. That's actually taken from the barge, and that's the line of sight that that our man Pete sees up there. And then you see the start-finish line. Look at the north turn. As we see the Cellular come down, as we get that shot of them really pounding off that north corner as they come down to the start-finish line, let's watch the Cellular as she comes through the line, and you can see the wide shot now. This is taken from the pit area, but shows her coming towards the buoy to the start line. Gets an idea of how the course lays out now as well. And then we go down to the south corner as they come right into your living room there, and you get to see the tunnel in the air underneath those race boats. They rocket into that lower corner, and from there we go topside to take a look at what happens from the helicopter. There's the shot. The water condition's excellent right at the moment, actually a little on the flat side, as you can see. You zoom inside and see the scoring up action, and we'll watch those particular shots to see where everybody is in position with each other from the air. This is from the log boom. This is what the folks over the log boom see. You're looking south right now from the log boom and somewhat west. This is a shot you don't usually see because the left to right on your screen over the years has been actually a north to south run. This is a south to north run the Cellular is making, and this gives you a unique view. And the boat crews, by the way, Wayne, are watching this one particularly. Yeah. This is the best view they've seen of the back chute on Lake Washington.
That Chopper 7 camera shows us five boats in the water. Two, of course, are right there on the left-hand side of your screen, the three up at the top. It's so much fun as they start to cut through the infield, miss a buoy, watch for rescue boats, and try and get themselves lined up to come around and hit the clock.
Now, what you'll see is the Pringles attempt somehow or other to get this man, Chip Hanauer, on the outside. Chip knows that that's what Scott likes to do, and so he will try to stay away from Scott, which he so far is doing. We're coming up on the one-minute gun here shortly, and when we do, that's when the scoring up occurs. It is a slower racing, but it is racing of its own kind. Cutting across the center of the race course right now, and going over to the north corner as the one-minute gun fires, is the 7-Eleven. Out on the back chute is the Cellular. Also, we have the Pringles out there. Pringles not keying this time on Chip Hanauer. Chip is trailing them up a little bit into the corner, and we are going to now score up from the upper part of the course. You're seeing this from the north turn, and the boat that is in the number one lane, if you will, or closest to you, closest to the center of your screen, that boat is... That would be the Pringles, and at the present time, they're trying to get position. The Cellular 1 would try the buoy line, but she's trailing back. Set the lanes for you. Cellular 1 on the buoy rope. Outside, it will be the Mr. Pringles. Chip Hanauer trailing just a little bit to get into the setup there. A little on the early side, way outside, of course. That's the Mr. Pringles coming around the outside of the course, and he's going to put his foot in it. Scott Pierce is. There's a few seconds left before the start. They're all a little on the early side, and now they're getting after it. And Chip finally grabs the inside lane. Frank Kenny, lane two. Cellular, 7-Eleven, and on the outside, Pringles. And they were late to the start. Sloppy start this time. That's for Frank Kenny taking them down. As they go into the lower corner, Milner Irvin leads them in for Frank Kenny Toyota. He's on the outside with Chip Hanauer on the inside. And that's Pringles shooting by as they go into that lower corner. Coming out first without too much difficulty, Chip Hanauer on the inside in... The Miss Miller American. Good acceleration. Wider now is the Frank Kenny Toyota. That's the boat you see as she comes out of the south turn and starts down that back chute. In third place, 7-Eleven. Fourth place, it is the Pringles. In fifth place overall, the Cellular as they come down the chute. Now up into the north turn. Rooster Tail flying off the skid fin of this boat, the Miller American. And the water is tough up there. It's rough. They're churning pretty good out of that quarter. Good turn straightaway now for the Miller. Second place to Frank Kenny. Good run for Milner Irvin. In second place for that Turbo Allison, former Budweiser Hall. Third place is the 7-Eleven. Then we've got traffic on the outside. It's Pringles on the inside. Cellular. Those are the two boats trailing back there. As you can see, all five of them headed down into that lower corner.
Shot. What a great shot. I love it.
The lead Rooster Tail, that's this boat, the Miller American. We have a 120.5 first lap. Miller goes through the corner. Now we've got some traffic in the second and third positions. Miller's clean and out of the lower corner now on lap number two. But the traffic is in second and third and in fourth also. Here's that traffic we're talking about, the 7-Eleven. Steve Reynolds, remember, he's got to get points. And he's shooting past Milner Irvin, the Turbine, and the Turbo Allison. And now Milner finds some beans. And they're side by side. Steve is testing them. They're not particularly hot, but Steve doesn't want to go any faster than he has to. As we get into the upper turn now, you can see those two boats. Miller American is clear out front now. On the inside with the lane advantage is the Frank Kenny Toyota, and on the outside, them come down. Beautiful shot from Chopper 7. Shows you about four boat lengths at 300 feet per second. Only a tick of the clock difference. That's real close racing. And back behind that particular picture is the Mr. Pringles. But now we're looking at your leader, Miller American, through the lower corner. She's out ahead by a good quarter mile now. And Chip has no problem as he goes up the back chute on lap number three. There you see those parallel rollers we talked about earlier today. They are in the same line of travel. And the sponsons fall in those little holes right and left. Now well established in second place is Steve Reynolds in the 7-Eleven. The Frank Kenny has decided not to challenge, try to get points, get scored. Remember, she got no points in her last outing either. But the Pringles is running back in fourth place overall. Three laps now over for the Miller American. Scotty Pierce is working from the third position toward the second position, being held now by, of course, the Frank Kenny Toyota, 119.0 for lap number three for Chip Hanauer. Well out front, Steve Reynolds has established himself in second place. The race now is for third and fourth. And let's have a look at the third and fourth lineup, because we've got the Frank Kenny Toyota in third, but the Pringles is moving up. And there is the differential right there. The boat on the outside or toward the center of your screen is the Pringles. And on the inside and up to the top of the screen is the Kenny Toyota. That's the 7-Eleven off the lower corner. Now, trailing on the outside, having a problem, is this boat. And that is the Cellular One. She's been actually down for some time now, for about the last three quarters of a lap, having a difficulty. Four laps are over now for this boat, the Miss Miller American. And that is riding beautifully. There's Todd Yarling. Troubles with the Cellular One, the U-22 from Madison. Both Madison boats are having a hard time out here in Seattle today. Miller American, your leader. Chip now goes through that lower corner. 7-Eleven is in second place. Here's the shot from Chopper 7. The 7-Eleven looking good. 300 points, just exactly what Steve felt he had to have. And he had to work another boat or two for it. There's the Frank Kenny Toyota as it passes the disabled now U-22 Cellular. And the Pringles in fourth place overall is continuing the chase. There's the difference between the boat on the left, the Kenny, and the Pringles. And Scott is moving up just a little bit, keeping the pressure on.
That could be a very important point standing for those 225 for third place.
Yes, it could. Look at Scott now in the upper part of your screen. Let's hold with this shot now as Scott works the outside. Scott working the outside and on the inside boat in the center of your screen. That is the Frank Kenny Toyota. Okay, Scott knows now that he can overtake this boat if he has to. The lane advantage, obviously, on the inside is the Kenny. And Scott's working on the boat, but he's not going to work too awfully hard, because this is the kind of a situation where when you decide to take a sporting shot at somebody, it's also the time when you break something.
Classic pictures from Chopper 7. Excellent. All of our camera people doing a great job, but our hats off to Bill Heinlein, who's hanging out of that thing shooting this.
All right, Scotty comes out wide. Miller American has already finished lap number four and is on the way to the checker. 7-Eleven gets the checker now. Miller's already gotten the checker. Pardon me. We went back into the third and fourth race there. 7-Eleven's gotten the checker as well. And the checker goes out for those two gentlemen, with Frank Kenny holding off the Pringle. Milner Urban goes into the lower corner. .7 for Chip Hanauer on the final lap. So Miller has no problems whatsoever. She's back at the dock already with an 800-point total. There's Chip taking the helmet off. Pretty good afternoon for Chip. He's making it look easy.
He is at that.
There's the Cellular One making it look difficult. And there's the 7-Eleven. And that boat has its 300 points, and that just might well be. We dropped another boat with the Cellular, it looks like. We just might have enough points with the 7-Eleven to get Steve into the final heat.
Cellular One picked up 225 for finishing third in 1A. But then with a DNF here, that 225 is not as many as 300, and the 7-Eleven just picked that up for second place.
That's right. Steve coming back home now.
We'll have a happier guy to visit with us and interview when he gets up here. I know that. He didn't like that first heat at all.
I believe that's true. The Cellular people are pretty upset, though. The folks from Madison, the U-22 and the Miss Madison, coming all the way out here and just having a day that they just soon forget.
Yeah, they're not going to make the show unless there is a consolation we'll know later. Look at that beautiful boat. Isn't that pretty?
Some kind of boat. That boat looks so fast just sitting there. It'd get a ticket, I think.
Looks like it's moving when it's standing still.
Mr. Pringles returning to the pit area also. Scott Pierce game. but didn't want to break anything. Just lay back. Here comes, of course, the Kenny Toyota with Milner Irvin.
You know what they're looking like now with that enclosed capsule? The Trans Am car is coming at you. They really are with that.
Yes,
with that
they are.
Capsule, yeah.
It also looks like Skywalker can climb out of one of them anyway,
true.
Too.
So
here comes Mr. Pringles back.
2A, as predictable, until the final lap, Miller American runs it and picks up the 400 points. Steve Reynolds picks up the 300 for second place, and it may well put him in the big show at about 4:10 this afternoon if everything runs on time. That's what he wanted to do. That's what he and Mike talked about, and he went out and did it. And he did have some competition. Let's say that for him. It was not handed to him. He had to run a couple of boats down because he was not in that spot when they came across the line.